We have to see Professor Dumbledore immediately.
I'm afraid he isn't here. He's at the Ministry of Magic.
He's gone? But this is important. It's about the Philosopher's Stone.
How do you know?
Someone is going to try and steal it.
I don't know how you three found out about the stone, but I assure you, it is well protected. Now, please go back to your dormitories, quietly.
We need to get past Fluffy, the three-headed dog. We need to go to the third floor. But Professor Dumbledore said it is forbidden. I do not wish to die a painful death. Have it your way then, I'll go with Hermione. And give up the chance of being a hero when I save the Philosopher's Stone? No way, I'm coming. Shh, he's sleeping. Look, there is a trap door. I'll go first. If something bad happens, get yourselves out. Wow, wicked. Are you guys okay? Alohomora. Where are we? Is it a graveyard? I don't like this at all.
This is no graveyard. It's a chessboard.
There's a door. I bet the Philosopher's Stone is right behind. What do we do now?
It's obvious, isn't it? We've got to play our way across the room. Harry, you take the empty bishop square. Hermione, you'll be the queenside castle. As for me, I'll be the knight.
But Ron, are you sure you know what you're doing?
Ron, I have utmost confidence in you. But no offense, I'll be more at ease if we analyze the situation systematically using data science.
None taken. Luckily for you, I have records of all our previous chess games. Take a look, Hermione.
Oh, so we have 8 variables. What's ECO and ELO?
ECO codes is a classification system for chess opening moves. Chess openings can be divided into 5 volumes, from A through to E. The ELO rating system shows the relative skill levels of players compared to other players. You and I have an ELO rating of above 2500, which means we can be considered as chess grandmasters. I do practice a lot with my mom and dad, so the results column would indicate who wins.
Indeed, 1-0 means that the person who plays the white pieces wins. 0-1 means that the person who plays black wins. And half means draw, as both sides have half a win. We can see that white wins 30% of the time, and black wins only 20% of the time.
This makes sense. We know that white has an advantage in chess. Let's do some data pre-processing. Chess ELO ratings are not linear. The difference at the grandmaster level is greater than the difference at the intermediate level. Let's calculate the z-score of each player, and then the exponential of the z-score.
What's a z-score, Hermione?
A z-score tells us the position of a raw ELO rating in terms of its distance from the mean when measured in standard deviation units. Take a look at this chart. The z-score in a normal distribution is symmetrical. That means if we draw a line down the center, which ends at 0, it is equal to the mean of the z-score distribution. And so, 50% of the raw ELO values occur on the left of the mean, and 50% of the values occur on the right side of the mean. Here, the standard deviation is equal to 1. So, the z-score tells you how far away a value is in terms of standard deviations from the mean.
Got it! Let's calculate the exponential of the z-score using the exp function. We call this value adjusted white ELO, or adjusted black ELO for the white and black players respectively. Then, we can calculate the difference between the two values and call it adjusted ELO difference.
We can use the hist function to check the distribution of the ELO difference.
It looks like a bell shape, which is a normal distribution.
That's great, Ron. This means that the ELO rating difference between white and black players isn't skewed, and there isn't a large difference in skill level.
Let's try some modeling. Since there's 3 outcomes, white win, black win, and draw, we can use the multinomial regression technique to predict the chess outcomes. Remember our sorting hat episode? We use multinomial regression to predict who sorted into which Hogwarts house. Go ahead and check out the sorting hat episode for more details on multinomial regression.
let's split the chess dataset into the true and test datasets using a 70-30 ratio. Then, we can use the multinom function from the nnet package to fit a model on the trained dataset. So the outcome is who wins at chess, and the predictor variables or features are adjusted ELO difference, ECO category, which shows chess opening moves, adjusted white ELO, and adjusted black ELO. Do we need all these features, Ron? Let's use the step AIC function from the MASS package to select features. The step AIC function essentially simplifies the model without impacting its performance. That's a good idea, Hermione. So it looks like the adjusted black ELO feature is dropped from the final model. That's right. Now, let's run the predict function to predict the winners in the trained dataset. And we can build a classification table to show actual values against predicted values. The correct predictions are highlighted in red. We can calculate the accuracy of the predictions using the sum of diagonal elements divided by the total observations. And the accuracy is 52% for the trained dataset. Let's do the same for the test dataset. Oh, geez, the accuracy is also 52%. This is bad, Ron. Really bad. A draw happens at 50% of the time, so this is only slightly better than predicting a draw. What's happening? We need to start the game now. Ron, you don't suppose it is going to be like real Wizards Chess, do you?